Unleashing a storm from the decks of aircraft carriers, the MiG-29K Fulcrum roars into the sky, a symbol of naval air power that's not confined to Russian waters. With arresting hooks and reinforced landing gear, this fighter jet defies the challenges of sea-based operations, mastering the art of catapult launches and deck landings. Soaring over the Indian Ocean, it's the backbone of India's naval air arm, a testament to its adaptability and international reach. Born in the crucible of the Cold War, the MiG-29K has undergone a transformation that defies its age. No longer just a relic, it's been retrofitted with modern avionics, including the Zhuk-ME radar, and an arsenal that ranges from air-to-air missiles to anti-ship weaponry. Serving in multiple fleets across the globe, this versatile jet showcases how innovation can breathe new life into older frameworks. During the last years of the 1960s, the Communist East and the Democratic West were engaged in an arms race to develop the most advanced weaponry, spacecraft, and fourth-generation jet-powered fighters. At the dawn of the 1970s, the United States introduced iconic aircraft, such as the General Dynamics F-16 Fighting Falcon, McDonnell Douglas F-15 Eagle, the F-14 Tomcat, and others. The Soviet Union also devised its fair share of powerful aircraft, such as the MiG-21 Fishbed, the Su-15 Flagon, the MiG-23 Flogger, and the revamped MiG-27. Mikoyan OKB and other Soviet aircraft firms sought to challenge the latest American developments directly and began working on state-of-the-art fourth-generation fighters. This need was crucial for the Soviet Navy, which sought to assert its dominance of the high seas with a supersonic carrier-based fighter. In 1974, the Soviet command issued requirements for a new fighter to replace the MiG-21, MiG-23, and Su-15 series. Mikoyan engineers decided to work in a two-engine design layout that eventually became the legendary MiG-29. Unlike the boxy and bulky MiG-25 Foxbat, the MiG-29 featured a forward-set cockpit with a raised fuselage spin, twin engines buried in the fuselage side by side, and an elegant wing leading edge. The design was a considerable upgrade over its predecessor. Eventually, it led to several successful variants, one tailored for the interceptor role and fitted with increased fuel capacity and radar. The other was a dedicated multifaceted tactical fighter, envisioned to operate at shorter ranges and be easier to produce. The MiG-29 was officially born in 1974 and reclassified as a lightweight fighter to become the direct competitor of the F-16, while the Su-27 Flanker was developed to counter the American F-15. Still, there were more unique variants of the MiG-29 to come. The MiG-29 KVP was one of several variants derived from the original MiG-29. This prototype, with a reinforced undercarriage, a robust tail, and an arresting hook, was developed specifically as a requirement from the Soviet Navy. It was dubbed KVP, Korotki Vzlet I Posada, or Short Takeoff and Landing MiG. The inaugural flight of the naval variant took place in August 1982 and marked a historic milestone after several trials, pushing the prototype to its limits and revealing its capability to take off from a ski jump. Nevertheless, results showed that for the MiG-29K to be truly successful as a carrier fighter, it required more power and a larger wingspan. Consequently, Soviet engineers drew inspiration from the advanced MiG-29M and radically transformed the design of the naval version. The result was a redesigned carrier-borne fighter with a new undercarriage and expansive folding wings. This definitive version of the MiG-29K was simply dubbed the ship-based MiG. Unlike the standard MiG-29, it featured a multifunction radar, a cockpit with monochrome displays, and the revolutionary HOTUS, or hands-on throttle and stick controls. Furthermore, air-to-air active homing missiles, anti-ship ordnance, and precision-guided weapons joined the arsenal of this naval variant. Other details included engine inlets with retractable grills to safeguard against collisions. The maiden flight of the revamped MiG-29 variant occurred in July 1988, with renowned test pilot Tokhtar Abakirov at the controls. A year later, in November 1989, the first MiG-29K took off and landed on carrier Admiral Kuznetsov, proving the fighter's naval prowess. Tests on Admiral Kuznetsov unveiled remarkable capabilities, such as springboard-assisted takeoff, precision landings, and the possibility to operate under tropical conditions with a ship speed of 10 knots. Despite the impressive capabilities of the navalized MiG-29, the entire program came to an abrupt halt with the collapse of the Soviet Union, leading the new Russian Navy to adopt the Su-33 as its carrier aircraft instead. Still, the program would see the light again a decade later, thanks to an unexpected partnership. In 2004, the MiG-29K program was revived thanks to the Indian Navy when it acquired the Soviet-era carrier Admiral Gorshkov from Russia. The hybrid aircraft carrier and cruiser underwent a remarkable transformation that comprised arrestor wires, and a takeoff ramp materialized, proclaiming the arrival of the MiG-29Ks. Although India intended to acquire the Su-33, it ultimately opted for the MiG-29K due to its size to allow the carrier to have more aircraft on deck. The MiG-29K underwent a series of modifications for India's unique needs. The Zhuk-ME radar, the RD-33MK engine, and an expansive combat payload capacity of 5,500 kilograms were integrated. In addition, a sophisticated 4-channel digital fly-by-wire flight control system to ensure lethal precision was also added alongside 13 weapon stations. Other Indian requirements for an airborne warning and control system led to the dual-seat MiG-29K-UB. This variant, equipped with powerful radar and encrypted data links, ensured networked coverage, optimal electronic warfare, and long-range operations. The standard MiG-29K features a crew of one, has a length of 17 meters, a wingspan of 12 meters, and a height of 4.5 meters. It weighs 11,000 kilograms and has a maximum takeoff weight of around 24,500 kilograms. The MiG-29K features a robust design with cutting-edge technology. Its broader and foldable wings provide it with unmatched versatility for carrier-based operations. With an arresting hook and a reinforced corrosion-protected fuselage, it's engineered to weather the most demanding maritime conditions. Likewise, the MiG-29 is powered by two RD-33MK engines designed for the rigors of carrier takeoffs and landings, and providing it with a top speed of around 2,200 kilometers per hour, a cruising speed of 1,500 kilometers, and a range of over 850 kilometers. Loaded for combat, the MiG-29K boasts a payload capacity of 5,500 kilograms. 13 weapon stations are ready, allowing it to carry an array of air-to-air missiles, precision-guided munitions, rockets, and bombs to handle various missions. The MiG-29K also has unique avionics, such as the Zhuk-ME radar, that pierces through the air for enhanced situational awareness. Its monochrome display cockpit with HOTUS controls ensures the pilot makes the best split-second decisions in battle. The MiG-29K and the F-16 are both powerful multi-role fighters with distinct strengths and weaknesses. For instance, the MiG-29K was designed primarily for carrier-based operations, excelling in maritime environments. Following this trend, its RD-33MK engine is also optimized for carrier takeoffs and landings. As a carrier-based aircraft, it was tailored with features like folding wings and an arrestor hook that are standard for carrier fighters. Armament-wise, the MiG-29K is equipped with a diverse array of weapons, including air-to-air missiles, precision-guided munitions, and anti-ship missiles. The American F-16, on the other hand, is a land-based fighter that, unlike the MiG, currently serves in more than a dozen air forces worldwide. Unlike the MiG, the F-16 is powered by different engines depending on the variant. This includes the Pratt & Whitney F-100 and the General Electric F-110. Like the MiG, it is equipped with a wide range of weaponry, from air-to-air missiles to precision-guided munitions, offering flexibility in mission profiles. It also boasts advanced avionics, including radar systems like the AN-APG-68. While not tailored for carrier operations, the F-16 is a versatile and widely deployed aircraft in land-based air forces across the globe. In essence, the MiG-29K specializes in carrier-based missions optimized for naval operations. Conversely, the F-16 is a versatile land-based fighter, celebrated for its adaptability and used extensively by air forces globally. Both aircraft exemplify excellence in their respective roles, reflecting the engineering skills of their respective nations. Russia's 279th Shipborne Fighter Aviation Regiment stood at a crossroads in early 2015. Its Su-33 fighters, seasoned warriors of the skies, faced the inevitability of retirement. The solution for them to keep up with more modern aircraft was a substantial upgrade, arming them with the Gefest SVP-24 bombsight, a cost-effective solution for bolstering their ground attacks. Yet the fleet needed reinforcement. In a strategic move, the Russian Air Force turned to India's order of MiG-29Ks. The cost-effectiveness of this collaboration was clear. India's investment of $730 million secured 16 units, while producing 24 for Russia would amount to nearly $1 billion. The deal was sealed in 2009, and the MiG-29Ks arrived on Admiral Kuznetsov's deck by 2010. Furthermore, in 2012, Russia ordered 20 MiG-29KR fighter bombers and 4 MiG-29KUBR operational trainers. These new aircraft were destined to replace the aging Su-33s, ensuring the continued combat capabilities of the carrier Admiral Kuznetsov. Following this acquisition of Fulcrums in 2015, Major General Igor Kozhin, commander of the Navy's Air and Air Defense Forces, ordered the formation of a second fighter regiment, with the MiG-29K slated to become the vanguard of the unit, alongside some venerable Su-33s finding renewed purpose through an extensive refurbishment. 1 year later, in October 2016, four MiG-29KR KUBRs from the 100th Independent Shipborne Fighter Aviation Regiment joined Admiral Kuznetsov's air group in the Mediterranean, bolstering the ongoing Russian campaign in Syria. Yet, in November 2016, one MiG-29KUBR met an untimely end en route back to its carrier. India ordered its first batch of the carrier-borne fighter in 2004. The order included 12 MiG-29K single-seat and 4 MiG-29KUB two-seat fighters. The Indian Naval Air Arm received its first MiG-29K aircraft in 2009. Since then, the Russian MiG-29K and MiG-29KUB multi-role fighters have become the backbone of India's fighter wing aboard the Vikrant aircraft carrier. Satisfied with the capabilities of the Fulcrum, India signed a $1.2 billion deal with Russia for the additional delivery of 29 MiG-29Ks. Currently, the Russian aircraft are distributed among the Indian Naval Air Station at Hansa, the modified Vikramaditya Kiev-class aircraft carrier that first entered service with India in 2013, and INS Vikrant, the first aircraft carrier to be built by India. In late December 2018, while addressing the High Command of the Indian Navy, Chief Admiral Sunil Lanba noted, quote, "There's no issue on supplies of spare parts from Russia at the moment. The MiG-29K fleet has been performing well now." These claims were related to a series of malfunctions several MiG-29Ks suffered during training operations. Whichever the case, the issues were resolved, and the first Mikoyan MiG-29K landed on carrier INS Vikrant during night sea trials, earning praise from the Defense Ministry Atmanirbhar Bharat. The time-tested Mikoyan MiG-29 has seen combat operations in different regions worldwide. Nevertheless, the seasoned air superiority fighter had never faced the extreme weather conditions of the vast white desert, the Arctic. For the first time since the 1970s, the Fulcrum, the latest successor of the MiG-29, was deployed to the Arctic Novaya Zemla Archipelago in November 2021 for combat training exercises. The Russian Navy aimed to increase the country's zone of influence over its northern sea routes, including the Barents Sea. In a statement to the national news agency TASS, the Russian Navy's northern fleet said, quote, "The replacement of the flight personnel and MiG-31BM fighters of a separate composite aviation regiment took place at the northern fleet's Rogachevo airfield. They were replaced for the first time by pilots of deck-based MiG-29K fighters of the 100th Shipborne Aviation Regiment of the Northern Fleet's Air Force and Air Defense Army." The press release also stated the experimental combat duty operations would expand further into the North Sea route with the newly deployed Fulcrums. Russian naval officers expect the all-weather carrier-based MiG-29K will increase the operational capabilities of the 100th Shipborne Aviation Regiment with increased long-distance deployment. The MiG-29s have also been deployed to the Mediterranean Sea aboard the carrier Admiral Kuznetsov. Other Fulcrums will become part of the Russian Northern Fleet's 45th Air Force and Air Defense Army Anti-Aircraft Missile Regiment on the Novaya Zemlya Archipelago. still in service in Poland, Bulgaria, and Slovakia, the Fulcrum is expected to remain in the air through the present decade as it reaches the end of its service life.